It's the 28th of February 2017. It's very, very close to being Raspberry Pi's fifth birthday. And we got a treat for you. About 18 months ago, we launched Raspberry Pi Zero, which is was our $5 low-cost Raspberry Pi. And people have used it for lots of stuff. It's been pretty popular. But one thing a lot of people have been doing with it is plugging Wi-Fi and Bluetooth dongles into it to get some kind of connectivity. So what we're announcing today is a product we call Raspberry Pi Zero W. It's $10, and it's a Raspberry Pi Zero with the Wi-Fi and Bluetooth chipset from Raspberry Pi 3. And Roger designed it. Roger, what did we do?
We, as you said, took the reference design from Pi 3. We made it single-sided, and we added it into the Pi Zero design. So there's a lot of squeezing and pushing, but it's now fits on. It's now a very busy board. We've added in a new antenna from some people called ProAnt, which is a sort of resonant cavity ground cutout rather than a chip antenna, and it performs better than our previous antenna. It remains single-sided, and that means this is how they arrive to us. We only have to put it through the whole reflow process once, so normally you'd have to do both sides, and this single-sided, and we cut out 50% of the manufacturing time. It's brilliant in the sense that it's going to remove the need for using a mouse and a keyboard connected to the product, so you can have it hidden behind a TV or hidden away in a project, and you can just connect a mouse and Bluetooth, mouse and keyboard through Bluetooth, and same Wi-Fi as Pi 3.
Yeah. So one of the challenges with Pi Zero obviously is that it has a single USB port, and one of the reasons why we think this is cool is because it swept that USB port. You're no longer trying to fit all of your connectivity to the outside world through this one little port. You can use Bluetooth, mouse, and keyboard. We can imagine a lot of people in that kind of use case. Yeah. They're not even going to plug anything into the USB port on the Pi Zero. Now, lots of whenever we do a Raspberry Pi product, we always forget about putting it in a pretty box. Same with Raspberry Pi Zero. But we got talking to our friends at Canoe Du4 in Bristol, who did the official case for Raspberry Pi 3, and they pitched us something, and we loved it.
Yeah.
And now we got a case for Raspberry Pi 0 and 0 1.
Yeah, so this is the case. It follows a lot of the design aspects of the Pi 3 case. It's a very nice case. It comes with the base, which is the magenta part of the case. The base and three lids. It's never going to be pink. It comes with three lids: the camera lid, the camera lid, the GPIO lid, and the plane lid. So the GPIO lid allows you to plug in a connector into the top into the GPIO. The camera lid actually comes so you can actually get the cable that comes with it. It's a specially length cable so that it'll just plug straight in, and then your camera will then fit in here. It just connects in. And then closes up. And there's also the access to the pins at the back as well. So you can actually power from the back if you needed to. But that is an awesome case. I love this case.
So there we go. It's our fifth birthday. We've got Raspberry Pi Zero W at $10. We've got an official case. We've made something like 80,000 so far of the Zero W, and we're making about 25,000 a week. So we're kind of hopeful that it'll be in good supply. We've got new distributors for Zero and Zero W, covering most of mainland Europe and Japan, very shortly Japan. Happy birthday.